Community health-related information on the following show provides general information only. Content presented on any show by any host or guest should not be substituted for a doctor's advice. Always consult your physician before beginning any new diet, exercise, or treatment program. And now it's time for Pet Health Cafe, where your pet has a voice. And here's your host, Bill, the Pet Health Guru.
And welcome to Pet Health Cafe. Bill, the Pet Health Guru, along with my guest host, Dr. Michael Dim. How are we doing, Doc?
I'm doing well, Bill. Another busy week, right?
Yeah, and of course, with the holidays coming up and, you know, all of that stuff, you know, we're going to continue our summer fun series here. You know, all the things that we get to look forward to as health professionals that we have to deal with. We covered a lot last week, didn't we?
Yeah, we really did. We ran through quite a gamut of good information.
Yeah. You know, everything from, you know, the parasite things and, of course, the hot sidewalks and the contaminated lawns and a whole bunch of other stuff in between. And there was a whole bunch of stuff we didn't get to either. That was the interesting thing. That's why I figured we have to follow up. And it's probably the right time to do it because we're here coming up on the 4th of July weekend. And let's face it, that holiday isn't easy on pets, is it?
No, it's a tough one, you know, especially with the fireworks and the thunderstorms and, of course, you know, the barbecues and sometimes pets not getting the healthiest of delicacies from the barbecue. It can be a busy time of year. I mean, yeah. An active time of year for our animals and us.
It was funny. Last night we had a real bad lightning storm down here. And even though my raw fed animal and, you know, was just calm most of the time, there wasn't any of the shaking or, you know, that sort of thing, but she did want to stay pretty close to home.
Yeah. It's really it's a big challenge, you know, when these large storms just, you know, come on. Our animals certainly are sensitive to a lot of these things, that's for sure.
Well, they sense the, you know, the change in the air pressure and all of that too, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely. They sense the energy, the atmospheric changes. Our animals are really in tune with that and, of course, pick up on those changes long before we do. You know, they hear the storms, they sense the storms, and they know that they're coming. And, you know, the reactions can be quite dramatic.
Yeah, exactly. Now, one of the things that I wanted to get into a little bit is because of the season, of course, you know, for this particular weekend, we have to deal with fireworks. And, you know, we've done a lot of work with, you know, the mineral or the heavy metal toxicities like mercury and aluminum and things like that. And sometimes these events are what trigger some of these, basically everything from seizures to the high anxieties to attacking their own owners, don't they?
Yeah, you're right. These stresses in the environment, you know, bring out what those pre-existing toxicities and make them a lot more likely to express themselves, as you so wonderfully put.
Yeah. I mean, you know, we saw that with all those Yorkies we went through, you know, 10 years ago with the mercury poisoning from the vaccines. It was like, you know, they were perfectly docile animals and then they just got a little bit, you know, the separation anxiety and, you know, some of the destructive behavior. And then all of a sudden some event, and usually it was, you know, a thunderstorm or fireworks that just basically sent them into what is almost seizure-like. Yeah. And, of course, you know, the owner wants to comfort them. And a lot of these were older people. You know, you reach behind the chair, or reach behind the couch or under the table, grab them. And they just go crazy and they attack. And, you know, 2 minutes later, 5 minutes later, they're fine. Like it never happened.
Yeah, no, you're right. And, you know, their nervous systems are on edge because of the pre-existing toxicity that you outlined. And, you know, the storms just, you know, bring that threshold a lot higher, you know, a lot lower, that is, to trigger some of these susceptibilities that these animals already have. Like you said, it's a wonderful time of year to implement some detox protocols and heavy metal detox, that's for sure.
Yeah, you have to do it a little bit farther ahead than the weekend before. Although we do have a protocol that we've actually worked very, very well, and that's using, of course, the natural CBD oils and our stress and anxiety, which you can start a couple days before, because the herbs, the chamomile and the valerian are going to go to work almost instantly, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. And then you, like you said, if you start a few days earlier, you know, it'll be present in their system at a steady state, so that when the storms come, you don't have to say, oh my goodness, I have to reach for some acute solution when those products are already built up in the system.
Yeah, the heavy narcotics usually is what the vets prescribe. It doesn't knock them out. I had a case about, it's probably been 6-8 years ago, and where a client called me up in the morning, Bill, it's 4th of July. What do you have that's going to knock out my dog? Because he just goes crazy with it. And we got talking a little bit. And I realized that in that conversation that her dog, we were also treating for cancer. So I knew we had the CBD oil there. And I said, well, just, you know, we'll use CBD. And she says, it didn't work on the stress part of it. He's still always stressed and everything else. So I told her, I said, let's do it this way. Do your regular morning, middle day, and, you know, your evening feeding. About 6 o'clock, when the kids start playing around with the firecrackers, give them another dose of CBD. 8:30, give them another dose of CBD. And at 9:05, before all hell broke loose, give them one more. Right. She called me up the next morning and said, he slept through it all. And then she says, well, why wasn't it working on the everyday stresses? You know, the dog was still anxiety ridden and that sort of thing from time to time. But it worked this time. And I said, well, most of the time, the CBD was turning on the receptor sites for the cancer because the stress level wasn't high enough, that threshold wasn't high enough to make that the priority. But as those fireworks started and that activity started to increase, the body started turning on those receptor sites in the stress centers and kind of let the cancer sit on the back seat for a couple hours.
Right.
And, you know, it's amazing that the body does this. We can't control it, can we?
No, not at all. In fact, it's very similar to how we look at it homeopathically. When an acute stressor comes along, the chronic tendencies take a back seat, and the body shifts to dealing with that acute stress, like you said, and biochemically just shifts into a totally different mode.
Yeah. I mean, that's really, really interesting. So, I mean, you know, at least we got one of the tips out there that can happen this week if it's absolutely necessary. You know, we have product, and, you know, you can refer, clients to us for it as well. We can get it out. We still have time to get it out to them on deliveries or even UPS last minute. Tuesday.
The alternatives are, Bill. I mean, the alternatives for, you know, these thunderstorm phobias and fireworks phobias, I mean, what we're dealing with in the conventional vet clinic are stronger and stronger sedatives and tranquilizers that really have tremendous side effects. The number one drug now being used for this sort of thing is an old antidepressant called trazodone, which has...
I heard that this week, yeah.
Yeah, that's what the vets are reaching for now.
It's interesting when we look back at some of this stuff, how do we keep recycling these drugs that never worked in the first place?
Yeah, well, this is an outdated antidepressant that's used, I believe, for inducing sleep in people that have trouble sleeping. But, you know, we borrow their use in veterinary medicine, and there aren't even really any safety studies on its use. And the dosage range are kind of like a potpourri of various dosages, and nobody's really done the work and studies. And I've seen some animals have significant, you know, awful side effects from some of these drugs.
Yeah. And of course, it's not just, you know, the side effects can linger for a long period of time, can't they?
Absolutely. I had a client that called me today that was referred to me that this was kind of a similar related issue, but, you know, was given a sedative so that they can groom their animal. And ever since they've given the sedative to groom the animal's lethargic, not eating, and it was given, you know, a strong sedative. And these drugs, you know, build up in the body, and each animal has a different sensitivity to them. So, you know, every case is different. And certainly we want to ease our animals' comfort level or raise our animals' comfort level so that they can handle these things. But we have to keep in mind that a strong pharmaceutical can have, you know, other effects that can be longer lasting and cause other, you know, some of these animals are senior animals with pre-existing diseases and pathologies. And we're coming along with strong drugs like trazodone or an old one that we used to use, ace promazine. I don't know if you remember that one.
Oh, yes. That was like ancient.
Right. But that was what we used, you know, for thunderstorms. And, you know, and then people sometimes reach for the benzodiazepines, the Xanaxes and those kind of drugs. But really, we have in our toolbox, as you would say, certainly plenty of useful products that we can use. And homeopathically, we can give remedies like aconite, which is really good for sudden frights. Mm-hmm. We can use the flower essences. I found them sometimes very helpful. The, you know, good old rescue remedy can never hurt. You can combine that with using the CBD and your herbal botanicals.
Sure.
And another flower essence I found very helpful in thunderstorms and fireworks is one called Mimulus, which deals with fears very, very well. So we certainly have in our toolbox plenty of options for the guardian.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that's a good thing to know. Now, the other thing, of course, is on the same weekend, we have a lot of issues with travel. And a couple of questions that came up is, you know, the things that we have to look at when we're evaluating, vacation travel. And of course, this will also tie in with hurricanes if we have to evacuate, things like that. We should have our own little toolkit, if you will, of remedies and herbals and things that we should have available when we're doing this. But the compatibility of animals, too, and, you know, when you're traveling, you get a mixed household. You got two dogs and three cats. What are you going to do? You know, are they going with you or are they staying home? And then you've got the pet sitter type thing, boarding type things. These are all major challenges that we have in the summertime that we don't have most of the rest of the year.
Yeah. I mean, you bring up a good point with, I get the question all the time from my holistic clients. What am I going to do? I have to travel. I don't have a pet sitter, and I have to use these pet hotels or these boarding facilities that, God, are putting such stringent requirements to allow your animals to stay in these environments, meaning vaccines and flea and tick control and all sorts of other things that they require just to get in the door. You know, so it's problematic for a lot of people.
Yeah, I mean, my recommendation is if you can get somebody, you know, and start early, that they'll come into your house. That's always the best option, because that's going to be the least stressful on your animal to start with.
Right.
And you at least have still maintain control over, you know, the medications that you don't have to use, the vaccines that you don't have to get. And of course, the food, because, you know, so many facilities, will not allow you to bring your own diets. Especially if you're getting into homemade or raw diets or things like that.
Yeah, it's a shame. I mean, these facilities, they have stringent rules, and there's no reason. And I tell clients right up front, I say, you know, I know we need to travel and we need to run our lives, but, you know, when the animals are forced to take these biologicals and these pharmaceuticals and vaccines, I say you're putting your health at risk. I mean, it's like the animal's health at risk, you know. We have to find other solutions, like you said, pet sitters, other options that can help deal with the problem.
Yeah, I mean, I actually had a case many years ago where an animal came in very so-called allergic. We changed the diet, herbals and things like that. And the dog was doing fantastic, decided at the last minute to take a week's vacation and travel. The only place he could get to board it was his old vet. They would allow him to bring in cooked food, but not raw. So we actually did up the whole week's worth of cooked diets for the dog. And when he went in to pick him up, they brought out the bag of stuff for him to take home. And most of the diet was in there. And he started freaking out. And he says, well, what did you feed? Well, they came out with a new prescription diet that the dog really loved. And, you just really, really loved it. And then they handed him a separate bill for over $1,000 for allergy treatment.
Oh, my goodness.
with a dog that we had just cleared it all up on. You know, the horror stories you hear like this.
Yeah. I mean, it's just, it's a shame. I'll sometimes for clients try and write a note like that they're being treated by a holistic veterinarian. Some of the facilities will honor that, and that we don't want vaccines, and that they're eating special foods. Well, not special foods, but, you know, raw diets.
Right. Special diet.
And, you know, they've been, some of them have been receptive, others have not been. But just like to get around rabies vaccination, and especially in Florida with medical exemptions, we can certainly, as a holistic veterinarian, I'm certainly able to write these exemptions and hope that the boarding and hotel facilities for our animals will honor those things. And that's another option that I encourage, you know, the listeners to look into, whether it's from myself or other holistic vets that would be willing to do that.
Right, exactly. Yeah, and of course, like I said, some of this now carries over into the hurricane season. You know, if you're forced to evacuate, you know, a lot of the public facilities that they set up as shelters require, again, all kinds of medical documentation and preventatives and vaccines and all of that, don't they?
Yeah, they do. Just to look, even to go to a dog park, they require vaccines, much less these facilities that, you know, are congregating large numbers of people and their animals. And, you know, the red tape bill that's implemented in our society to be able to have freedom to move around and to function, it's just astronomical, the stresses.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, one of the things, you know, because it is in that season now, I urge our clients to start looking ahead, start stockpiling whatever you need. Make sure you get your paperwork in a convenient place. You know, one of the things, if you're feeding a raw diet, you know, if you're going to facilities that don't have refrigeration or that sort of thing, you know, we have you know, our dehydrated treat line, but that's actually dehydrated food. I mean, they can live on that for weeks, if not months, if they had to, couldn't they?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, they look in the wild, the animals are scavengers, and sometimes they're not getting the ideal prey, and depending upon the environmental circumstances. And so the same is true when we're having these, you know, emergencies in the hurricane season. You know, they'll be fine, you know, just, you know, eating, let's say, dehydrated for, you know, for variable periods of time. You know, their health is going to be stronger, especially if they've been eating, you know, the My Paleo Pet diets, you know, the most of the year.
Yeah, even in house, I tell people, you know, it's like, what happens if my electricity goes out and, you know, that sort of thing? And I said, well, leave your freezer closed until, you know, you start to see water dripping out of it and everything's defrosted. And then go ahead and just feed it all off. Let them do a gorging meal or two. You know, right. Don't let it go to waste. And you know, they'll be, you know, I mean, in the wild, they'll gorge themselves. They may not go even hunting for another week or two.
Right. Yeah.
So it's a, you know, it's another option that they have. And then don't stress out about it, because again, you and I talk a lot about energy. If you're stressing out, you know, in the wild, what do the wolves and the wild canines and the wild felines and even the ferals do in a hurricane? They find a nice comfy spot, curl up, and basically just, you know, kind of relax, don't they?
Right. And of course, we're not dealing with the effects of vaccines and chemical, well, you are, I mean, to some degree in the environment, but not to the nearest degree that we are in our companion animals. So, but the wild animals, like you said, they're, you know, the wild ancestors of our animals, they're basically relaxed, comfortable, like you said, going in a safe space and not overreacting, that's for sure.
Yeah, and that's the important part about that is that, you know, they maintain that natural energy that we as humans don't have an ability to do sometimes, I swear, you know. And of course, they're picking up on our energy. And if we're all anxious about it, they're going to be trying to protect us.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's one of the things that they, you know, our animals worry about us, and they do take care of us. That's, you know, why, you know, dogs have been guardians of us for so, so many years. Looks like we're just about up against the break here. So when we come back, we'll get into a couple of other parts of this whole summer syndrome. Let's take this quick break right now.
We all want our pets to be as healthy as possible, and My Paleo Pets is the answer. Let us help relieve your pet of ear infections, allergies, scratching and itching, diabetes, joint problems, cancer, or other ailments by providing our naturally raised, raw, cooked, or frozen bio-complete natural diet entrees that are custom formulated to be species-specific and USDA approved. For more information, visit MyPaleoPet.com or call 954-971-2500.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me excitations.
Do you want to become a wholesale dealer or distributor of healthy and clean foods? Our friends and colleagues at BioComplete Natural Diets and Herbs provide only the best USDA human consumption grade Choice Plus meats, poultry, and seafood. Our food comes from pasture-raised and grass-fed animals, and we never add hormones, preservatives, or chemicals. Our clean and all-natural species-appropriate diets are made daily in small batches from local farm fresh dairy products. Over 100 organic herbal and botanical herbal products are available. Buy only the best and eat clean. To learn more, call BioComplete Natural Diet and Herbs at 954-472-1404 or visit BioCompleteNaturalDiet.com.
We're back here on the Pet Health Cafe, the show where your pet has a voice. This is Bill, the Pet Health Guru, along with my special guest host, Dr. Michael Dim. And we're just going through all the challenges that we run across this time of year with our pets. And, you know, the hurricane thing down here is a lot. We talked last week a lot about the excessive temperatures and keeping our animals cool and bug-free, which is an important part of that. But the other thing is we mentioned it last week, and we mentioned it a little bit earlier in the show, too. What kind of things should we have in our closet, if you will, in our pet's medicine cabinet, or shouldn't even call it a medicine cabinet, I guess we should just call it in their health cabinet, that we should have on hand from a homeopathic standard?
Well, it's a lot of the acute remedies that we use for various conditions are also excellent during the summer season. Remedies like belladonna, nux vomica, and arsenic amalgam, and, you know, Rustox and Arnica for traumas. I mean, it's a good group of remedies. And, you know, I know it's hard because just to say all those remedies on the screen here, it would be difficult. But people are welcome to contact me, you know, email me. I'll give them a list of homeopathic remedies to have on hand that can really be helpful during times of fright, during times of digestive upset, during times of any trauma that the animal may experience. And that's where homeopathy shines, Bill, during those acute situations. It really works wonderfully, you know, during those times.
Yeah. And of course, you know, on our side, of course, we like I said, we stock up on the dehydrated products that we have. You know, we've got a pain and inflammation formula. You've got the gastric, the good old fashioned herbals for all kinds of stuff like slippery elm and turmeric and, white willow bark for pain. Marshmallow root, again, for gastric type things, Epsom salts, so that, if they get a bite or they're some swelling or anything of that nature, and basically that's excellent for strains in that as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, Epsom salts are wonderfully healing. You know, I often have, people soak animals' sore limbs and dilute Epsom salts, and they do one. I mean, it's wonderfully soothing for us as well as our animals. Absolutely. Right.
And of course, one of our standbys is, the Sovereign Silver or Colloidal Silver products, for everything from an eye inflammation to, dirty ears, any cuts, scrapes, all of that stuff. That's an excellent product. Raw honey. They should definitely have either raw honey or Manuka honey handy because, especially toy breeds, if they go hypoglycemic on you, if you're not on a raw diet, or even seizures, it pulls out of a seizure almost immediately upon administration. These are things that you need to really have available, like I say, in your health box all the time. And of course, the other thing is good clean water. You know, our hydrolyzed, ionized water, you know, for hydration, because in times of stress, we don't think to drink, and they certainly don't think to drink, do they?
No, not at all. When they're in fight flight, they often forget that. That's for sure.
Yeah, it's, you know, so, I mean, these are things that are readily available, of course, at My Paleo Pet online or, you know, in the store. You know, they can order a lot of the things through you as well.
Yeah, they can go also with homeopathic remedies. Some of the pharmacies have acute kits that have a lot of the remedies I just, you know, mentioned quickly. And, you know, an acute emergency kit. And some of the big homeopathic pharmacies like Hahnemann Labs,
right,
Boiron have excellent kits that are great to include along right alongside the herbal botanicals. So, you know, we have to remember that. And it's not just, you know, we don't want to just have the allopathic things in mind. We want to remember that we can solve a lot of and prevent a lot of issues with the herbals and the homeopathics.
Yeah. And of course, again, with getting into that hurricane and travel part of it, one thing that we haven't mentioned is you need some sort of way to restrain your animal, whether it's collars and leashes or harnesses, crates and carriers, because in this, you know, in time of panic, you basically want to keep them, you know, as confined as possible, don't you?
Yeah, because they have a stress response and that creates all sorts of havoc. So keeping them calm and cool in those ways, Bill, are critical. Yeah, you know, they have these thunder shirts for animals. I've never found those to be very helpful. You know, those confined shirts that they put on them.
Yeah. It's funny. I got a call from a client yesterday afternoon up in Georgia, and she's like, okay, you know, the fireworks, that sort of thing. She says, I know I need to do something. And we've been working with them with diets with cancer animals and that sort of thing for years. And she says, we know the thunder shirts don't work. We know that the normal stress remedies don't work. You know, and I don't want to go to pharmaceuticals. Send me up to your kit. it's like.
Right.
Because even like we mentioned that, like some of the flower essence and stuff like that. Well, if the animal is in a pretty basic health state, those can be very helpful. But when you get to some of these animals that have been on bad diets and over medicated, they're kind of throwing away their money, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are. And I can't stress enough, Bill, the usefulness of, for fear and fright and intense symptoms where animals want to escape or restless. The remedy Belladonna and Aconitum are really two acute remedies that work quicker than any pharmaceutical drugs because they're acute situations. And you could give those remedies every few minutes during a critical episode, an acute crisis. And it's amazing how quickly they act. As soon as the granules touch the gums, sometimes. So, you know, great remedies to have in their toolkit and for these sudden situations where often things take time to kick in. Other modalities, other realms.
Right. And that's one of the things too. I mean, just to get into, you know, because we sometimes get into functionality, you know, something like CBD and some of your remedies, when you're giving them orally, they're quickly absorbed right through the mucous membranes of the mouth itself. So they're immediately in the bloodstream, aren't they?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I mean, with CBD, it's absorbed right through the sublingual areas, the tongue, the areas under the tongue. And with the remedies, it's an energy, remember? So as soon as those granules, the energy of the granules touches the oral cavity, you know, it's dosed. I often tell people that say, well, doc, when I dissolved in a little bit of water and my dog only took a little bit of it, or you know, a few of the pellets fell out of his mouth. Well, I said, did the pellets touch the mouth or touch the gums? And if they say yes, then the remedy was dosed.
That's so right.
It's very rapid. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. And, you know, and it's funny because when I move over to the herbal side, sometimes, that takes a little bit longer. But sometimes, of course, you know, you can end up with a little bit of, possibly a vomit or, you know, a little bit of diarrhea down the road, but that's also on the same standard. It's taking out the toxins that were causing some of these problems in the first place, that stress and anxiety.
Yeah.
So it's all working. The body knows exactly what to do all the time. We just don't listen to the body.
No, not at all. It's doing what it's supposed to do. Get rid of those toxins, like you said.
Yeah, but we got to quit putting more in. And that's probably the number one thing, you know. I think we did a lot here on all these things, as far as, you know, the summer type things. Is there any other summer things that you've thought of that's different?
I think you mentioned to me privately the incidence of pancreatitis or whatever that disease is that comes mm-hmm. up often in the summer months. Often it comes to, you know, again, dietary indiscretion, eating unhealthy foods, people feeding their animals, you know, unhealthy table scraps, you know, fatty, greasy things, you know, barbecued this, that, and the other thing. We're not talking about what they should be eating, which is what
right.
you offer My Paleo Pet, but that often leads to acute diarrhea, acute vomiting. But, you know, it's the disease pancreatitis is so overdiagnosed, but it seems that in the summer season, it seems to be one of the number one gastrointestinal diagnoses made in the conventional medical veterinary clinic.
Yeah. And the reason I brought it up is I've gotten several in the last couple of weeks that, you know, they went in for their routine and they get the blood done and it's like, it's almost like it's like pre-diabetic, you know, you're pre-pancreatitis. So we can sell you something more and scare you even more, into either diets or medications or, you know, I don't think there's a vaccine yet for pancreatitis, is there?
No, but, you know, they basically, when you bring that up, Bill, they're making recommendations based upon just simple lab values that might be slightly out of range. When I say out of range, different from their range, I should say.
Right.
And when I say different from their range, it doesn't mean that it's wrong. It's that individual's animal, you know, measurement at one moment in time. And so what will happen is if the enzymes of the pancreas, the lipase and the amylase are elevated, veterinarians jump all over that and say, your animal must have a touch of pancreatitis when there are no symptoms present of the disease or issues with that organ. So right. we have to keep in mind that it's the symptoms of the patient that should guide our treatment, not a lab test, not a lab value, which is so what my colleagues do very often in conventional veterinary practice.
Right. Now, we had a question that popped up here. How do you identify toxins? If it's processed, if it's got a chemical name, it's probably toxic, right. especially if it's sold as a, you know, FDA-approved drug.
Except for homeopathic remedies, they're FDA approved drugs.
Yeah.
Right. But you're right. If they're sold as FDA approved drugs, most of them.
Yeah. And you have to look, you know, beyond the first one or two ingredients. I mean, especially when you're looking at foods and, you know, realize that anything that's a processed product like a meat meal or a chicken meal, something of this nature, you have no idea what's in that recipe.
The byproducts, all that stuff.
Yeah. Anything that's rendered, of course, you know, and then even if you took like on a so-called good kibble, just the way they make it, that high pressure, high temperature for 4, 5, 6 hours, there's no nutrition left. And then they have to add in all these chemicals, which they label sometimes as vitamins and minerals, but they're really not.
Right. They're not at all. In fact, that's what hooks our animals on those foods. They, like we talk about, the flavor enhancers that hook, especially kitties. I just gave a lecture yesterday at Hippocrates here in West Palm Beach. And one of the audience members came up after my talk and said, my cat was eating raw food, was doing really well. You know, went into the vet's office, had to be boarded or stayed there for a few days, went on a kibble, and it was almost impossible to get the cat off the kibble.
Yeah.
You know, even just for a few days. Yeah. And so, you know, these foods are definitely problematic in what they're adding to it, as we go over so often.
Yeah. Well, that's just it with a lot of these, especially the synthetic sugars that they use, which are narcotics. When you're looking down the road, any remains in the body, just like drugs and people, you know, just one more, you know, one more hit and you're back on it. We're at the break again, so we'll be right back after this quick break.
Does your pet suffer from allergies, cancer, digestive issues, or joint and skin problems? These can be from poor nutrition, and My Paleo Pet can help. Don't let your pet suffer from poor diet and nutrition. At My Paleo Pet, we provide fresh human-grade, USDA-approved, BioComplete raw food entrees for dogs and cats. Whether you're looking for healthy food for dogs or natural herbs for cats, we provide you with exactly what they need to live a happy and healthy life. Our raw food for pets surpasses traditional raw dog food and raw cat food that you find in your local pet store. Our raw foods are made fresh on the premises, sourced from nearby local suppliers, and are made with only the utmost quality with specific nutritional and functional benefits. We deliver locally to areas in South Florida, including the Palm Beaches, and we ship frozen nationwide. At My Paleo Pet, we strive to offer the best in rotational diet formulations. Clean, raw, human-grade, fresh food in our eco-friendly, resealable packaging. For more information, visit MyPaleoPets.com or call 954-971-2500. If your pet is overweight, suffers from skin problems, or you suspect food allergies, My Paleo Pet is the solution for you. Our natural and fresh foods for pets are FDA approved and is sure to bring the puppy or kitten back into your pet. My Paleo Pet carries a full assortment of healthy, holistic, frozen, raw food entrees, all natural dehydrated treats, local raw dairy products, and herbal smoothies, as well as natural supplements, treats, chews, and grooming products. Products can be ordered online 24/7 at MyPaleoPet.com and shipped nationwide to your doorstep. Call 954-971-2500 to speak with our friendly staff today. Let My Paleo Pet help keep your pet happier and healthier.
All right, and we're back here on the Pet Health Cafe, the show where your pet has a voice. This is Bill, the Pet Health Guru, along with Dr. Michael Dim, my special guest host. Another question that had come in, evidently the vaccine things, we touch a lot of hearts and minds when we start talking about vaccines. And the question was, are vaccines a necessity?
The answer was one word, no. If you're going to look at me, I'm definitely considered an anti-vaxxer. I think any vaccine has the potential in any given animal to cause irreparable damage unless, you know, they're detoxified and put on appropriate botanicals and treated homeopathically. Of all the biologicals and pharmaceuticals that are out there, you know, I've seen more damage potentially done by one vaccine in a given animal than any other drug or biological. In fact, you know, I tell clients in my lecture, if somebody puts a dose of a pesticide on their animal or gives one dose, yeah, that animal is not going to be well, but that's not going to cause irreparable damage to that animal's life force. One vaccine, though, can. And so definitely you want to avoid vaccines as much as possible. The data on them is very scarce in terms of their safety, their efficacy, the true data. And so I would encourage the audience to avoid them as much as possible.
Yeah. And of course, you know, I've been sitting in that camp forever as an anti-vaxxer myself. And, the only animals that I ever had a problem with early in my career were when the new scientific diets came out and we were getting it free. And, of course, you know, trying to keep up with the vaccine schedules, which have been expanding and expanding and expanding over the last 50 years. I mean, and of course, we know that those toxicities go intergenerationally. You know, even with the rabies challenge, I mean, you know, when it was being done, and they're down like five generations with no more vaccines and still showing positive titers. Wow. It's an amazing number.
Right. But we know energetically what's called in homeopathy miasmatically. You know, diseases are transmitted epigenetically in terms of deeper than DNA, energetically through the ancestral lines. And so, yeah, it's at a very, very deep level. So it takes many, many generations to improve the health of conventionally reared animals often. I mean, many generations to improve the genetic stock, so to speak. You know, so, you know, when clients come to me and they start feeding raw diets and raising their animals holistically, there's still going to be times where they come in with some symptoms, both as a normal part of detoxification, but because of that generational effect, you know, unless they were reared from, you know, raw fed, vaccine free animals over generations, you know, it's very difficult to have pure health as we would define it in today's world.
Right. And of course, when we're looking at, you know, both homeopathy, herbals, and, you know, the diet itself, the ingredients that go into those have got to be the best we can get, don't they?
Absolutely.
I mean, I know there's a lot of homeopathics that are sold in retail situations that what would you trust them?
Not really. No, there's a lot of really questionable companies out there in terms of their trustworthiness and reliability.
Yeah. You know, it's funny because people call me up and I'll say, okay, well, we need this herb or, you know, we need to start feeding, you know, certain type, you know, more variety in meats. And it's like, can I go to XYZ and pick it up? It's like, I don't know what they've got in their packaging. You know, yeah. I know for the most part and you know, that when I look at it, of course, is most of the stuff is packaged in the cheapest plastic containers that you can. And that's a potential toxic dump in itself, isn't it?
Yeah. All the toxins from the plastic leach into the product. Sure.
Yeah. Especially in the summertime, because it's 120 to 140 degrees in the back of that UPS truck or that, you know, post office truck, isn't it?
Yeah. It sure is. And we have to keep that in mind when we're shipping products. Sure. I just ordered, my homeopath just recommended a remedy for me, and I ordered it from the homeopathic pharmacy because I didn't have it, and they were saying, you know, we ship it on ice, and we, you know, because remedies are antidoted when the temperatures rise that high, their effect can be, it's one of the few ways of antidoting remedies is extremely high temperatures. So if homeopathic remedies are exposed to those high temperatures, they become inactive. And so when shipping them or when storing them, we have to make sure that they're at, you know, relatively cool temperatures.
Right. And, you know, and of course, you know that most of our products are packaged in glass, and the only ones that aren't are the frozen diets. And we're not going to get the leaching in the freezing process that you do in the heat process, obviously, from the plastic. And to be honest, there's really not, you know, when it comes to especially meats and that sort of thing, there really isn't a good way of packaging it, because even in glass, because of expansion of product, you know, we pack our bone broth in it, and you know, we have to have special jars so that the expansion doesn't pop the glass.
Good point.
Yeah. You know, because of the expansion. So there's a lot more that goes on in the backside of what you and I do, that is designed to basically get you the cleanest, least contaminated, least, problematic products that we can. And it's not easy today. Even the herbals and making, you know, a lot of herbs and botanicals are used in making homeopathic remedies, finding good, clean sources of, you know, organically raised or wildcrafted, sustainable. It's a bigger and bigger challenge every year, isn't it?
It sure is. You know, with the expansion of a polluted, toxic world, it's one of the biggest challenges we face, Bill, in the current life.
Yeah. But, I think in the last 2 weeks, we've given a good roadmap for navigating the summer seasons with your animals. And, of course, it's going to be the same in the wintertime, but scaled down a lot more. We're not going to have as wild of type of problems that we would have in the summertime. which, you know, kind of gives us a chance to have take a deep breath and relax a little bit, right. You know, and not have to worry, you know, enjoy our pets a little bit more in the cooler weather and right. not have to worry about those bigger challenges.
Yeah. And then the even the allopathic drum dies down a little bit in the winter where, you know, they move away from just pounding the drum about parasites and heartworms and all the rest of it. So.
Well, yeah, that's generally when they go into their disease of the month club, you know, wherever, you know, something comes out in the journal and all of a sudden every animal in the world's, you know, susceptible to it.
or pet dental month, as we would say, you know, yeah. as we talk about it. And, you know, you and I have spoken about on many shows about how many decades ago dentals were a rarity for our animals. Yeah. And all of a sudden it's, you know.
Okay, we're down in the 2 minute mark now, Dr. Dim. Where can people get a hold of you?
Well, they can go to my website, which is drdim.com. That's Dr. Dim spelled out, drdym.com. And that has my contact information, my email address, phone number, and I do try and return emails within the day. So, you know, definitely email me if you have any concerns or if you want an idea of what acute remedies to have during the summer season. I'll be happy to share those with you.
Yeah, yeah. That would be a great idea. You know, if you get it in a list form or something like that, you know, we can get it up on our social media as well. And, you know, let's keep this list going. As far as myself is concerned, of course, you can reach me through mypaleopet.com, Pet Health Guru on social media. And, you know, I'm just kind of like all over the place. It's been an interesting journey, especially the last couple of years. With sure. all the changes, you know, I'm really grateful to our audience. You know, we want to build it. You know, we would love for you to share this and to like it and to subscribe. That helps us out and the algorithms and things like that. And, you know, it's going to be an important part of getting this message out. And that's what we want more than anything else, is to help as many pet owners, pet parents that we can. And, you know, on the other side of it, we also help out with humans as well. So, because once you learn, you learn.
I tell people that all the time, you know, there's what you sell is for both people and their pets.
Yep. So we're at the end of the show, Dr. Dim, a pleasure as always.
Yep. Another great show.
We'll chat after the 4th of July again. And we need a good topic. And if anybody has a topic that they want us to talk about, please email us or message us, because that's always helpful. Good night, folks.
Good night, everybody.
How healthy is your pet? Does your pet suffer from ear infections, scratching and itching, diabetes, cancer, or other ailments? If you want the best health for your pet and to prevent or relieve these symptoms, My Paleo Pet is here to help. The key to healing is a clean, natural, appropriate rotational plan. Start your pet on the healthiest diet ever with our easy online ordering guide and nationwide shipping at mypaleopet.com. Call ahead for your takeout order or stop by our location on West Sample Road in Pompano Beach, Florida. Affordable solutions for your pet's health issues are here today. Call to speak with our friendly staff at 954-971-2500.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me excitations.
Do you want to become a wholesale dealer or distributor of healthy and clean foods? Our friends and colleagues at BioComplete Natural Diets and Herbs provide only the best USDA human consumption grade choice plus meats, poultry, and seafood. Our food comes from pasture raised and grass-fed animals, and we never add hormones, preservatives, or chemicals. Our clean and all-natural species-appropriate diets are made daily in small batches from local farm fresh dairy products. Over 100 organic herbal and botanical herbal products are available. Buy only the best and eat clean. To learn more, call BioComplete Natural Diet and Herbs at 954-472-1404 or visit BioCompleteNaturalDiet.com.